So hi everybody, my name is Laura Tomasia. After 7 years postdoc, I've become a teacher educator, and I currently work in a university college UC Limburg. UC Limburg, sorry. And I work in a bachelor program for future physics teachers in secondary school. And I'm also active in a research group that's interdisciplinary around teaching, the research group Art of Teaching. So you see, 20% approximately of my time is dedicated to teaching. So it's higher education, but you see, it's a very different setting with respect to university teaching. It's a classic classroom situation, small groups, and I have to do the experiments as well. And then I'm also active in professional development for teachers, so teachers who are already working in a school, but they come to us to learn something more. And you see here one about CERN, and one in CERN that we organize with teachers and teacher students. So for the rest of my time, I'm involved in educational projects at Belgian Flemish level and at European level. So this is, going back to the talk of Ricardo, this is also teamwork, often with big teams. And it's a form of design-based and practice-oriented research, where we develop educational trajectories that are new for young people and for teachers. We develop all the supporting material, we test it, and also we disseminate it. But the thing is that, of course, if you want to do the project, first you have to win it, and then before winning you have to write it. So a lot of my job is actually also project writing, and if we get it, also coordinating the general management of the project. So these projects have a very concrete output. We always make something, we make handbooks, we make websites, we organize events that really take place for young people. A couple of examples is the quantum spin-off project that is connecting young people with quantum physics and with the applications in high-tech research and entrepreneurship. And a second example is the project Research in Motion that is about how you should present research in school and trying to find different way to talk about research in school. So if you want to do this, you should be prepared to study. So for me, it took 3 years to get the C1 proficiency level for the local language. Of course, if you do it in your own country, your native speaker, you don't have the problem, but I had it. You need a pedagogical degree, so it took me 3 more years of studying in the evening to get that. And then, of course, I had 4 years previous teaching experience already here at the KU Leuven. It was also important for me. So my advice is that if you're interested in going in pedagogy, you do at least part of this work during your PhD or postdoc, because otherwise, well, it's too much and also they don't hire you. So you should also be prepared to change. Again, I want to connect to the talk of Ricardo that said you can have identity problems. Because you identify yourself with the theoretical physics, I also had and probably still have the problem. And then people shake their heads and say, something really happened to you, what are you talking about? And if I look at this picture now, I might say, I see something very different from what you probably see. I see an educational situation. I see actually what people call a community of practice. And here I want to refer to François Englert, and he says, scientific research, something like that, you can get it taught. It is a craft that you have to learn by watching from a master who takes you on as an apprentice. The only valid pedagogy is watching. So this is something about education, how you educate people to do research. So I don't know really what I'm using or what I'm not using from my background. I can give you a honest account of what people are telling me that I think I'm using. So they tell me I have this crystal clear logic in very accessible text, and also abstraction, making diagrams that have the essence of something which is useful for projects. They say you've read beautiful projects, sense of aesthetic feeling of things, and also, of course, the powerful use of the blackboard. In research, they say I work at double speed, which is not always appreciated. That I have some kind of natural research attitude. I do everything when needed, so the problem-solving attitude has already been mentioned. And then, of course, no problem with big, complicated things, like the European dossiers of 200 pages. Also, less positive things, that I'm a perfectionist, hypercritical, with the taste for content discussion, which outside of exact fields sometimes is a bit complicated. And also maybe the last thing I want to say, I encountered some bias and prejudice in the beginning when I was looking for a job. People told me, with your background, fundamental research, you will never be able to do applied stuff. You will never be, your teaching experience at the university is useless for concrete teaching. But of course you have to find people who give the opportunity to show you, to show them what you can do. And I was lucky that I found these people and I'm actually quite happy with my job. So good luck for the rest of your career.